let's now look back at some of the action from that round. He went headhunting, landed, nearly got the finish, too.
A lot of coaches tell you don't headhunt. In this case, he's been headhunting, and he landed a big enough shot to truly put his opponent on notice.
Okay, round two, you ready?
Let's go. All right, round two.
Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this one? Look at how he turns his hip into that leg kick. Digging kick.
Oh, nice job to block the kick.
Keep moving. Protect your face. Hands up.
Look at him chopping the wood. Chop the wood with those leg kicks. Look at him working at trying to shut the liver down.
All right, so he's landed some good shots. You hate to be overly critical, but nothing really in terms of combinations tonight.
Well, the jab has been looking great. How about jab, jab, right hand?
Right.
Because eventually you're gonna have to put something on your opponent that's gonna really make him pause. What a fantastic wrestler. Great takedown.
Johnson gets the single leg takedown. I love watching this guy move on the ground. Another nice transition there.
Such a high low.
Oh, watch guillotine here.
All right, well, both fighters pretty comfortable on the ground, DC, but you got to be very careful hanging out here for too long if you're his opponent. Now trying to hip escape.
He's just trying to move out of this position up the bottom. The Kimura is not the arm. It's the shoulder pressure that usually makes you tap.
Oh,
man, that was slick.
All right, working inside the now open guard of his opponent. Uh-oh.
He's throwing up a triangle. The guy on his back is very good at submissions, and if he's not careful here, he's going to get stuck, and he will have to submit.
Working off of his back here. Looks like he may try to hip escape. Dillashaw's back in full mount.
Now the guy's got arm bar. He's attacking it on it. Gotta be careful, armbar. Now he's okay. Now he can escape.
All right, so you gotta be careful playing on the ground with this guy. You don't want to mess around for too long.
Now he's on top of him looking for the finish.
Final seconds here of round number two. Take a look back at some of the highlights. He has had his kicking game going early and often tonight.
I mean, on point, right? He knew that this was going to be a way for him to take control of this fight. He's used those kicks to really put him out ahead, and I'm not sure if his opponent has the ability to adjust and stop him from landing these over and over.
This next round, you really want to focus on ground control. You have to set up your takedown. I want you to maintain a dominant.
You ready? You ready?
Third round underway. Dillashaw gets caught with that punch. He's treading water now. Gotta find a way to move those feet. Well, we'll see if he can turn this defense into offense, but he's doing a great job blocking shots here tonight.
As of right now, he's thinking more defensively. Fantastic takedown win.
Back to the stand-up now, both fighters upright.
Big knee lands right through his opponent's midsection.
Johnson's got the tie clinched. Let's see what he can do with it.
Hands up, hands
Oh, vicious kick to the outside of that lead leg. You got to start checking these, man.
You can check these kicks, or you're going to be limping around the octagon very short.
Check yourself before you wreck yourself.
That is, oh, man, this dude is good.
Oh, straight right.
Big kick.
Well, he continues to do a nice job here defensively protecting the head and sort of maybe letting his opponent gas out a little bit with all the volume.
Oh, there we go.
Oh, he postured up there, gained some valuable separation.
And now the grounded pound starts.
Oh, he lands another takedown here, just doing a nice job, not telegraphing his shot, clean entries. The Olympian's kind of like what he sees.
I mean, over and over, he gets to the legs before his opponent reacts. By beating him on the entry, now it's up to the opponent to keep up. But this guy's playing chess. His opponent's playing checkers. He's playing chess. He can't keep up. Once he gets to his legs, he's got to beat him defensively before he gets his hands locked around his legs or his body.
Beautiful movement, hip work on the ground here, just outstanding with the transition.
He is not staying in one place on the ground. That's very important.
Dillashaw's back in full mount. Posturing up now.
And now the damage is about to start.
All right, bottom fighter here, maybe looking to hip escape, DC. Johnson's lower jaw does not look good. I don't think it's broken, but starting to show some obvious signs of swelling. Oh, nice job using his strength there to posture up. We'll see what he can do now.
He's gonna start looking to land big shots from the top.
45 seconds remain in the round. 45 seconds remain in the round. All right, 45 seconds now to go on the round. 45 seconds remain in the
round. Caught up in the matrix, virtual digital minds. We don't memorize phone numbers or directions when we drive. We don't even have to go shopping to get our food and bargains. We only push a button, we don't even have to try.
Can't even lift an eye away from my phone. Talking to Instagram live just so I don't feel alone. Flooded my Twitter feed with my deepest feelings and thoughts. My page is public, but my sense of conversation is blocked. I validate myself through followers just to feel important. Instead of living in the moment, I much rather record it. Nobody knows my first name, but know my Snapchat handle. I'm just a millennial, you're trapped in social media standards.
All right, coming up next, it's a welterweight showdown between George St. Pierre and the UFC Hall of Famer, Matt Hughes.
Ready? You ready to fight?
All right, so the fight is now underway. On one side, you have a fighter who does everything well, taking on a true grappler on the other side. Going to be interesting to see how long.
I mean, Damian Maia may be the most specialist type of grappler in the UFC. This guy resembles him in a number of ways. Let's see how he manages this fight against a guy that can do just about everything inside the octagon.
The Hall of Famer Hughes gets caught with that punch. Not the easiest guy in the world to hit, but he got caught there. Connects with a right.
Boom.
Big knee. Oh! Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by this gentleman.
Kick to the body now. That one won't land.
Recover, recover, move and recover.
And he lands the knee to the the body now.
You can really limit the mobility of your opponent with those leg kicks.
And both guys really throwing with authority.
Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this one?
Duffs the takedown, no problem. Oh, huge knee to the head. He could be in trouble here. Oh, straight right. Oh! All right, so a nice job there defensively to raise the guard and prevent any damage.
Those hands never leave where they're supposed to be. And if you do that, most times you will block a shot that's incoming. Very tricky when he throws that body. Big, powerful punch lands. Now he gets back to range.
Oh, knee strike right to the body.
Jab hurt him a little bit.
Oh, he lands another strike to the body, really starting to connect on a lot of shots to the midsection, and these will take their toll as this fight goes into the latter rounds.
He is throwing a fast, straight, hard jab. That's not a feeler jab. That's one that's really knocking the head back.
Well, he continues to do a nice job here defensively, protecting his head, raising the guard, and really frustrating the offensive fighter a little bit.
Lesson one in boxing class, hands up, chin down.
The Hall of Famer Hughes gets the takedown late in the round. That's useful. Oh, he postured up there, gained some valuable separation.
And now the ground and pound starts.
Round two next. All right, here we go with round two. Round one, pretty good, not great, but some action on both sides.
We can't always hope for fireworks, John. Yeah. Sometimes you gotta deal with the ebbs and flows of a fight. In round number one, so both guys have success. Let's see who really charges out ahead in the second round. Beautiful punch.
Much improved defensively as he blocks the shot. Timing his shots nicely here, champ.
He's doing a great job of mixing everything up and using a lot of diverse strikes.
Both fighters exchange in the pocket here. All right, so a near perfect entry there, and finally he gets his first takedown of the fight, and they say if at first you don't succeed, try again. Was able to get him down there.
Persistence pays, and that's what we saw with this young man. Over and over, he shot for takedowns, he tried to mix it up, and he got defended. But eventually, he got it done. Now, what does he do with this top control?
All right, so he's landed some good shots. You hate to be overly critical, but nothing really in terms of combinations tonight.
Well, the jab has been looking great. How about jab, jab, right hand?
Right.
Because eventually, you're gonna have to put something on your opponent that's gonna really make him pause. I believe the jab is working so well, if he drops a big...
One back. Let's take a look at the replay of the knockout just a moment ago.
It was right hand after right hand after right hand. Finally, he found the one that hit the exact sweet spot that ended his opponent's night.
Now we go inside the octagon. Bruce Buffer with the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dansby.